So before getting into, you know, the individual aspects of Sonu's music, I mean, just what was Sonu's philosophy? What was his idea of music? First of all, singing for singing. You may be wondering, what is singing for singing? But if you really question, you know, you may be singing for so many other reasons. Singing because today I have a concert. Singing because I have a class today. Singing because my parents are asking me to practice today. Singing because I have a, you know, competition in the next week. But how many times we just sing for the sheer pleasure of singing? I mean, just enjoying the beauty of it. But if you listen to Sonu's music, it's just that. That is the, I mean, that is why everything else doesn't matter. Subbudu has written, there are so many anavasyam in his music, but it is because it is Sonu that anavasyam becomes anavasyam. it doesn't matter, because he is able to get away with that, and he is still able to create the real impact of what music should do, right? That, and then there's absolutely zero inhibition in what he does, right? He doesn't, I mean, somebody, I mean, Sangeeta Kalanithi, Sanjay had compared Sonu to Shevak. You know, if you really notice how Virendra Shevak plays, right? I mean, it can be something from sublime to absolutely ridiculous, right? But you do something ridiculous, but the next moment you completely forget it, and the next ball, you just hit a sublime shot, it goes to a sixer. In some ways, Sonu's music is like that. I mean, he has absolutely no problem trying something, and then if it doesn't work out, it doesn't affect him. It doesn't bog him down. He just carries on. Because he is singing for singing, right? And it's an experience. And then when the person himself is, I mean, that is the beauty of, you know, what in the, you know, the audience connect. How can an audience connect with another person, right? Because the person himself is not there. He just loses himself. Then the audience have no option but to lose themselves. So, that connect, you know, he was completely unconventional, but there are others also who are unconventional. The important thing to note is his unconventionalism had no arrogance. It was natural, not for the sake of doing or not for showing that he is something different. There is absolutely no, I mean, and every time he sings some great phrase, right, you can immediately see that he is acknowledging the roots. He would sing a mono and say, "Idella Maharajapuram." And then he would sing a beautiful phrase, and then he will show like this, you know, when he was singing, and then to acknowledge that this is Rajaratnam Pillai. And he would sing a Kararapriya and then say, "Ella Ayyar." And then he would acknowledge Shemangudi Srinivasa. So, I mean, and that shows the humility of the man, and he's always conscious of where he has drawn things from. And he felt that it was important to acknowledge that as well. It is very, very important, because a lot of youngsters would come, a lot of people who don't know would have come. For them, it's an education. And even, I mean, why leave that, you know? He would sing a beautiful phrase, and then say, "Ayyo." You need that, because as a student, you don't know. Because, next time you would listen to it, right? You put the record, why did Sonu say "Ayyo"? Why did he pass there? Why did he choke with an emotion there? There is something there. It is not country. I mean, some of his critics say that he did drama. This is not drama. There is actually an aesthetic element in there, which is why he did that. And the audience connect, I talk, right? It is almost like a personal experience of each and every person who is sitting there. I mean, I have not heard Sonu live, but I have felt that in concerts of Mandalin Srinivas, right? You go and sit there, you feel like the person is exclusively playing for you. No, you mean, rest of the audience doesn't matter. He is doing something for me, you feel that, right? When Tendulkar was in a speak, each and every Indian, you know, felt like, you know, he was doing something for me. He was actually playing for himself. But then you felt as if, you know, that is the connect you have, right? So I will play an example where how he connects. This is actually quite funny. We'll talk about it. So he starts singing Manirang. guy starts walking away. He just says, okkar yaar, my pallavi paada sonna. He has requested for a pallavi. He remembers. When that fellow walks away, he connects it in. He says, you asked for a pallavi, now you are walking away. So he actually sings an elaborate manirangu. Then he sings a pallavi, so making him sit for a more. But you think that fellow could have felt bad. He will cherish that, right? So actually called me, made me sit there. He had connected as an individual, right? Which is amazing. I mean, this is how you connect with people, no? I mean, he need not have done that. There are thousands of others who are sitting there. Why should he stop a person who is walking away, right? And you look at that music. He is celebrating each and every moment, no? See, there is no baggage. He is not bothered about what he knows, what he has sung in the past, what critics think, what purists think. Nothing matters. He is celebrating each and every. This is one, again, a misconception because of some of the popular songs of Soma. Some of the popular songs are so rich in emotional content, and then obviously the recordings after late 1970s, where his voice also had a tendency to choke. There are people who have written articles that Somu's music has an inherent sadness, and but actually that's total rubbish. It is extremely emotional, and when the emotion meant something which had to reflect sadness or a very poignant moment, it was able to reflect that. But there are other emotions also. There's a complete, total happiness, gay, abandon, celebration, everything you can spot in music of Somu throughout the years. There is absolutely no question about that. I think it's our own perception and our own spin to what we are hearing and what we have heard. But if you really objectively analyze all the recordings, you cannot restrict Somu to only one particular emotion. And of course, he had a passion to present novelty. One thing you can repeatedly find, people who have reached the top, there is a tendency that they think audience expect this, I should deliver this. And then that's when their fall starts, right? Then they think, and probably, by the time, they realize it's too late. But then their music becomes restricted. But if you really analyze so much music, he was always looking to present something new. To an extent that it becomes, it becomes too much for people. Can I hear something which I've heard already? You feel like asking him that. It becomes too much. But you can feel that passion for novelty throughout, and each and every element of, be it Varnam, be it compositions, be it Alapana, be it Virutam, be it the final Tukda, be it Hindustani, you take any element of it, there is absolutely, he is always looking to do something which you are not expecting. There's a recording where he says, the Mridangist is anticipating something in his playing. He completely changes and said, "Ninga kadakala pona nanga mekala povom." Which means, if you think that I will go in the east, I will actually go in the west. But he doesn't care about where he is singing, what the audience are thinking. He's having fun, right? And then, that is a prime element. First of all, why you guys are learning to sing is to enjoy. Everything else doesn't matter. That is a first lesson. If you can learn that one lesson from Somu's music, that is enough. And of course, as we already talked, he was not shackled by grammar. And as I already said, he is the first Rasika. And then through him, we can become better Rasikas. And he had utmost respect for listeners. There are witnesses who say that he would have sung a song in Kalyani, someone else would come and ask for a, he would have arrived late, he would ask for another song which in the same raga, he would sing because of it. Listener wants. And then completely immersed, thereby, he is also immersing the listener. That's an element. With that, we will get into the each and individual aspects of Somu's music.